trouble for the Spanish side or still likely that they'll go through?
It's a tough one. It's a really tough group. That much we know. As far as Spain are concerned, they've got Australia up next. And, you know, they started, as I said, with six players who had begun that Euro 2020 semi-final. Pedri, who seems to be just playing football all the time these days, was the pick. An injury to Dani Ceballos in the first half really unsettled them. They never really clicked. They never quite found their way through against a really well-marshaled defense. Ahmed Hegazi of West Bromwich Albion was really impressive for Egypt. It was a strong Egypt showing, to be honest with you. But, you know, there's a little bit of heat on the pre-tournament favorites because of that result already.
Well, John, speaking of that heat and on the pre-tournament favorites, we've obviously outlined a few here that certainly have some work to do, maybe some disappointing first match there. Which of those favorites that maybe isn't playing up to snuff at the moment would you say there is the most heat on?
I would say probably the Spanish. You know, they really need to turn this around. For the Australians, it's going to be a free hit for them. They play with you know, a really nice condensed style. They play brilliantly on the break. They use the wingbacks to great effect. So, you know, if they deliver again, that could be something. The only thing I would say, though, Mark, is given the intensity of this tournament, you know, these guys, I mean, all of these teams are going to have to play three games in the space of something like 6 days or something like that. And the conditions at this time of year in and around Japan, whether you're in Sapporo, Kashima, Tokyo, Yokohama, on the outskirts of Tokyo, wherever, really hard, really, really tough. So I think we're going to see a lot of changes in these sides. And I think we might just see some really up and down results